When William died, bloated and exhausted at the ripe age of 60, his attendants stripped his body and scattered. What mattered now was who would hold the land he'd conquered and how. It had all been his, and it was he who'd decided. On his deathbed in Normandy, he handed out the spoils. He gave his eldest surviving son, Robert, his Duchy of Normandy. But it was the younger son, the red-haired William, William Rufus, who the conqueror willed should be acclaimed King of England. And the youngest, Henry, was told he would have to be content with £5,000. But Henry was his father's son. Content? With £5,000? Was that likely? Key to the plotting that followed was that, of course, none of the brothers was content. Henry stirred the brew of resentment that made Robert try to take the Kingdom of England from William, and William try to take the Duchy of Normandy from Robert. And Henry was always changing sides, weakening them both. Eventually, Robert, tiring of the whole struggle, decided it would be more satisfying to fight Saracens than his brothers, and went off on crusade. William was now secure and powerful, and Henry changed his policy. He was now William Rufus's very best friend. The Bishop of Lincoln later said that when Henry praised anyone, he was sure to be plotting that person's destruction. It does seem as though Henry concentrated on quietly stirring up discontent among churchmen and barons in England, which was not hard, as William Rufus needed their money and had little to offer in return, except to give to some what he'd taken from others. And besides, William Rufus wasn't their kind of chap. He didn't marry, he had no children, and as one chronicle puts it,
all things that are loathsome to God and to earnest men were customary in this land in his time. And therefore he was loathsome to well-nigh all his people and abominable to God.
Which is, of course, homophobic chronicles speak for being gay. On the 2nd of August in the year 1100, both William and Henry were hunting separately in the New Forest. It was the last day of William Rufus's life. His companion Tyrrell immediately fled and disappeared abroad. William's body was abandoned where it lay, at a spot still marked by this stone. The next day, local peasants took it in a cart to Winchester. Henry had arrived before them. Winchester was where the royal treasure was kept. He demanded the treasury keys from the guards. They refused to hand them over, saying that Robert, his elder brother, was the rightful heir. Henry drew his sword and declared that no one should stand between him and his father's scepter. Resistance collapsed, and when the peasants arrived with their cart, the lords of England were busy electing Henry as their king, the first elected ruler of England since Harold Godwinson. The Bishop of Winchester refused to give the corpse a Christian burial. Out of respect for his royal status, William Rufus was nevertheless interred under the cathedral tower, and when that collapsed a few years later, everyone said, "Told you so."